Hello everyone, my name is Daniel and welcome back to my channel, TechRite. Today we are going to be talking about the best Canon lenses that you can get for a decent price that you're going to need to have a well-rounded photography portfolio. If you don't mind, before we get started, to click that subscribe button so that you can be notified when I post another video. All right, so the first thing that I want to talk about is I'm filming on the Sony a6300 because I like the 4K video. But when I take pictures, I actually enjoy using a Canon camera. For the past couple of years, I have been using the EOS Rebel T6i. Starting out, this camera actually did everything that I wanted it to do. It has the flip out screen. It has the touch to focus. Basically, it did anything and everything that I wanted it to for photography. So if you would like a good camera that takes really good pictures at a decent price, I highly recommend getting a Canon Rebel series camera. So the first lens that we're going to be talking about today is the 18-55mm Canon EFS lens. Now this lens did come with the kit when I bought the Canon camera, and it's a very good lens. This is the lens that I actually started out filming YouTube videos with. The range from 18-55mm on this lens is actually one of the most versatile things, and it's most common that you're gonna need, whether you're shooting video or you're just starting out in photography. Mainly that's why it came with the kit. However, this thing, I still use this thing constantly. On the side of the lens, you do have the autofocus and manual focus adjustment. If you turn on the autofocus, it's going to allow the lens to work with the camera to automatically zoom in or change focus, depending on what you want to do with it. Now, this does have a minimum focus ring of 0.8 feet, so it's not going to allow you to get really up close and personal and get a sharp focus. However, that's not necessarily the reason that I purchased the lens. This thing did come with the kit. However, I mainly used this for YouTube videos starting out when I was helping take photos on the side. I didn't really take it seriously at that point. So if you're looking for just general photography, the kit lens is really probably going to be all that you need. Now, the next lens that I want to talk about is actually my favorite lens. It is the 50mm EF lens with the 1.8 f-stop. Now, this lens is actually otherwise known as the Nifty 50 lens. Now, the reason that this thing is my favorite is because of the 1.8 f-stop. Now, for those of you who don't know what an f-stop is, or you're just starting out in photography, the lower the f-stop, the more light that the lens is going to let into the sensor, which is gonna give you a more crisp image, and it's actually gonna give you more of a bokeh effect, which is that blurry background that you want whenever you're taking pictures. So if you're shooting in low light situations, or you just want something that you have a little bit more control, whether it be in a studio setting, or if you just want that blurry background really bad, this is going to be exactly what you want. The only drawback to the Nifty 50 lens is the fact that it is just 50 millimeters of a lens. So you don't have any zoom control whatsoever. What you see is what you get. And the last lens that we're going to be talking about today is the 10-18 EFS wide angle lens. Now, this lens is known as the vlogging lens because of the extremely wide angle that you get. Whether it be photography or videography, you can take this lens into tight corners, nook and crannies, and essentially make it look like you have a lot more space than you actually do. If you're, you know, strictly vlogging, holding the camera out, then this wide angle lens is going to allow you to have a extremely wide image and get your entire body of what you're trying to film in the image. One of the reasons why I do like this lens is because you do have a bit of zoom to play with. Obviously, it goes from 10 to 18, and the f-stop on that changes from 4.5 to 5.6 when you do. However, it still is a very good lens, especially if you're going to be taking your camera outside or if you're just trying to film in a room where you don't have a lot of space. This is going to fix you. All right, you guys, so that is just my thoughts and quick review on some of these lenses and what I think that you're actually going to need in terms of having a well-rounded arsenal when you're starting out taking pictures. If I have missed anything or you guys have any other questions on things that you want to see or reviews, please put those in the comments down below. Make sure you like this video because I hope that you did. And be sure to hit that subscribe button so that you can stay tuned for more of my videos when I post them. My social media and everything that I film with is in the description box below. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. I love all of you. Peace.